The pipeline function is the most high-level API of the Transformers library. It regroups together all the steps to go from raw text to usable predictions. The model used is at the core of a pipeline, but the pipeline also includes all the necessary pre-processing, since the model does not expect text but number, as well as some post-processing to make the output of the model human-readable. Let's look at the first example with the sentiment analysis pipeline. This pipeline performs text classification on a given input and determines if it's positive or negative. Here, it attributed the positive label on the given text with a confidence of 95%. You can pass multiple texts to the same pipeline, which will be processed and passed through the model together as a batch. The output is a list of individual results in the same order as the input text. Here, we find the same label and score for the first text, and the second text is judged negative with a confidence of 99.9%. The Xeroshot classification pipeline is a more general text classification pipeline. It allows you to provide the labels you want. Here, we want to classify our input text along the labels education, politics, and business. The pipeline successfully recognizes it's more about education than the other labels, with a confidence of 84%. Moving on to other tasks, the text generation pipeline will autocomplete a given prompt. The output is generated with a bit of randomness, so it changes each time you call the generator object on a given prompt. Up until now, we've used the pipeline API with the default model associated to each task, but you can use it with any model that has been pre-trained or fine-tuned on this task. Going on the model hub, hugginfest.co/models, you can filter the available models by task. The default model used in our previous example was GPT-2, but there are many more models available, and not just in English. Let's go back to the text generation pipeline and load it with another model, distilled GPT-2. This is a lighter version of GPT-2 created by the Hugging Face team. When applying the pipeline to a given prompt, we can specify several arguments, such as the maximum length of the generated text or the number of sentences we want to return, since there is some randomness in the generation. Generating text by guessing the next word in a sentence was a pre-training objective of GPT-2. The fill mask pipeline is a pre-training objective of BERT, which is to guess the value of masked words. In this case, we ask the two most likely values for the missing words according to the model, and get mathematical or computational as possible answers. Another task Transformers model can perform is to classify each word in a sentence instead of the sentence as a whole. One example of this is named entity recognition, which is the task of identifying entities such as persons, organizations, or locations in a sentence. Here, the model correctly finds the person, Sylvain, the organization, Hugging Face, as well as the location, Brooklyn, inside the input text. The grouped entities equal true argument use is to make the pipeline group together the different words linked to the same entity, such as Hugging and Face here. Another task available with the pipeline API is extractive question answering. Providing a context and a question, the model will identify the span of text in the context containing the answer to the question. Getting short summaries of very long articles is also something the Transformers library can help with the summarization pipeline. Finally, the last task supported by the pipeline API is translation. Here, we use a French-English model found on the model hub to get the English version of our input text. Here is a brief summary of all the tasks we've looked into in this video. Try them out through the inference widgets in the model hub